muốn là như vậy thì anh em mình cái gì đến làm quen để mình có học hỏi với nhau. Nhưng mình đã đến đây cả một năm rồi, chứ đâu còn gì nữa.
Em cũng tới đây chơi cũng cả năm rồi, nhưng mà tôi nghĩ là cũng phải
What I object to thông cảm is nhau, they all stick together, you know? I mean, here we all are, in a pub, and they never come over and bloody talk to you, do they?
Not good enough.
I mean, don't get me wrong. I'm not a racist or anything. I don't mind them being here. But I reckon they ought to make an effort. Try and fit in.
Well, why don't you go over and talk to them then, Ronnie? Buy them a round of drinks.
Get off.
I reckon you ought to make an effort, Cosmo.
Yeah, try and fit in.
What do you reckon, miss?
What are you grinning about?
Oh, I won first prize in a fancy dress.
Oh, good on you, Min. What did you go as?
I went as an Aussie. Oh.
That's great. Your work's really terrific, Min. How about we try and get you some work experience at an advertising agency?
Yeah?
Yeah.
I start work experience next week.
Oh, yeah.
In an advertising agency in the city.
I thought you wanted to be a teacher.
Get off.
Wrigley, hip and
penny.
Hi.
Hi. Hold the line, please.
Hi, I'm Gerard. Joanne and, Tran, is it?
Min.
Pardon?
Min.
Oh, you got Tran down here.
Oh, well, that's my surname.
Tran Min. Oh, right, of course. You guys write your name back to front. Fantastic. I love it. Come on up and I'll show you around.
Can I help you?
We're image makers, okay? Client comes to us and says, sell this. First thing we do is research. We find out who drinks soft drink. We knock on people's doors, we stop them at the supermarket, we ask questions, we get figures. Say the figures tell us kids drink the most soft drink, kids between 7 and 11. Let's say we find out something else. It's mum who pays for it. So what do we say to mum in our app? We say, if you pop a few of these cans in your shopping trolley, you're being a really good mum. The kids are going to love you. The whole family's going to be happy. Simple. I think you'll enjoy it here. You know, we have people from all walks of life. Women, Joanne, are in some of the top positions in the agency, and we're proud of them. And what's more, we'd have no hesitation in taking on an Asian person, for example, if he was willing, a hard worker, enthusiastic. Yes, you'll find Wrigley, Hip and Pemby a good place to be. We're all one big happy family here.
Are all your family here?
No, actually I came out with my cousin.
Yeah. Must be really weird for you, coming here and everything. What's up?
Oh, I was just thinking about something that Jared said. You know, something about happy families.
What do you mean?
Oh, my cousin and I, we were staying in this boarding house.
Uh-huh.
And one night, my cousin got bashed up by this drunk. He was off his head. Anyway, someone called the police. And the landlady pretend nothing happened. And that's what she said. We were one big happy family here. She didn't want any trouble.
We've got problems, Jerry. Look at the figures. Our claim on the national market's down to about 12%. We've got to face facts, Jerry. Sales are on a downhill slide. Bottom's falling out of the market. To be perfectly frank with you, Jerry, I'm worried.
Oh, I can see that, Frank.
I'm really worried. And let me tell you something else. The Australian public are drinking far less beer than they were 10 years ago.
It's a problem, Frank.
And let me tell you something else, mate. It's not just our problem. It's a national crisis. This country's going to the dogs. And let me tell you something else, mate.
What's that, Frank?
It's not just the money. It's the principle. I care about this country, Jerry.
Oh, I can see that, Frank.
Fact is, we're losing our national heritage. A bottle of beer, Jer, is as much a part of this great nation as gum trees, Ayers Rock,
Bondi Beach.
Thank you. If the people of this nation are not prepared to sit down and have a beer together, then the future of Australia is looking very grim.
They're drinking wine, Frank.
That hurts. That hurts, Jerry.
Wine consumption's up, Frank. They've captured more and more of the market.
Okay, Jerry. Okay. They've pushed me this far. They're not going to push me any further. I'm declaring war, Jerry. Total war.
We're talking big bucks, guys. He wants a heavyweight TV campaign, radio ads, newspapers, magazines, bus sides, billboards, you name it. In the next 3 months, Aussie Lager has got to be the name on everyone's lips. Got it?
Sure.
Right. I thought the team should be Hank and Tony. Pammy, I reckon you should stick with the cutie pie account. Just love the stuff you're doing with the lipstick. Great. Now, we have to get in touch with the ordinary Australian bloke. What does he want out of life? How does he feel? We're talking mega, mega bucks, guys. We've got to pull it off. Joanne, I reckon you should stick with Pammy. Min, you can come with us.
And here I am, stuck with Cutie Pie.
The name on everybody's lips.
Hey, that's not bad.
You know what I think the problem is, guys? The whole image of Aussie Lager's wrong. It's dated. Frank's still living in the 50s. He's still thinking in terms of the Ocker. The Ocker's dead, let's face it. The target group is men aged between 21 and 35. We have to understand the new Australian man.
You mean Italian or something?
No.
Why not, Jer? We could go multicultural. Greeks, Italians.
Don't be ridiculous. We're talking mass market. We're talking about social scenes, beer drinking situations.
So?
So you don't see Greeks and Italians and Asians standing around having a beer together, do you?
Sure, round at Hank's the other night.
Yeah, but that's different. It's not going on out there.
Well, your old man like a beer, Min?
He's in Vietnam.
Oh.
Listen, the consumer wants to see a real Aussie up there. He wants to see someone he can relate to. He wants to feel his beer is part of the Australian tradition.
Sure, but what's that, Jerry?
Well, it's about fair play, honesty, friendliness, being a man's man. You know, one of the boys, generous with your mates. What we have to do is create an Australian hero.
Tall and good looking.
Successful in business.
Triumphant in sport.
Adored by women.
Loved by men.
Admired.
Admired.
I'll leave it with you. You're on the right track.
I suppose it is true, you know. I mean, you don't see an Asian, a Greek and an Australian standing around having a beer together, do you?
Not at our place, you wouldn't. Although, come to think of it, Mr. and Mrs. Maggiore from next door come over every now and then. Well, they're Italian. Oh, but I guess we know them, so it doesn't seem strange.
Yeah, I reckon you should tell Jared that. He's convinced it doesn't happen.
Out there, in consumer land. I really don't trust that guy. His eyes are too close together.
Yeah, that's what they said about me. My eyes are too slanty.
Oh, I didn't mean that.
It's okay. But it's the same thing, though, isn't it?
Sometimes I think I'm just wasting my time here.
How come?
Because whenever the big campaigns come in, and I mean the really big ones, Jerry goes straight to the boys. Pammy, you're doing great stuff. We wouldn't want to distract you. And of course it doesn't matter what Hank and Tony might be doing, because Pammy will finish it off, won't you, Pammy? And after all, Aussie Lager is only the biggest account we've ever landed. And well, we're talking a lot of money, a lot of responsibility. You understand.
Well, he told me that women are in some of the top positions.
We are. I am, but somehow when it comes down to it, it's just...
Pammy, listen, sweetie. Tony just reminded me, it's Jerry's birthday on Friday. We thought we'd have a few glasses of champers, you know, a few nibbles, you know, that sort of thing.
Great.
The only thing is, Tony and I are really flat chat. I mean, this Aussie Lager thing's a real headache. Would you be a sweetheart?
Hank, I've got a deadline on Friday.
I'd do it myself, honestly I would. But it's a nightmare in there. We're up to our necks. Go on. Please. Think how happy Jerry's gonna be. Hmm?
Oh, all right. Hank.
Ah, you're beautiful. I love you. Isn't she beautiful? Well, to get back to work.
You were telling me about the successful career woman?
Very funny. Now, I was showing you this lipstick commercial. Now, you see, what we're trying to say is,
that the kind of brand you choose is making a statement about the kind of woman you are. Well, have a look at this. The successful woman is graceful and dignified. She knows her own mind. She knows how to please men, but she knows when to say no. And she never loses her cool.
Pam!
What?
Have you seen my car keys?
No.
Look, I'm sorry about this. I've got a luncheon appointment in 20 minutes. I can't find them anywhere. They're on a bright red key ring. Take a look over there, would you, Joan?
Oh, Tony!
Ah, voila. I'll catch you later, girls. Don't work too hard.
Couldn't you just murder it?
That'd really be losing your cool.
They moved in next door to George now. Not just one or two of them. George says there's about 10 of them there, coming and going. The front yard, oh, what a disgrace. Such a pity. Used to be very nice, that street. And of course, I keep parking over his driveway. He can't get his car out.
Yeah, brand new cars too, I suppose.
Well, that's the government for you. Hands out, left, right, and center. Did you want something?
No. No, thanks. What are you staring at? Eh?
You, I said, what are you staring at? You're deaf as well as stupid.
That'd be right. That'd be bloody right.
Come in here. Think it's a land of milk and honey. This is a great country, thanks to people like me.
Go home. You and all the rest of your bloody Ching Chong mates.
Well, who is this little toff? Hardly recognize you.
I'm a successful woman, Mrs. M. Graceful, dignified, totally confident of my femininity. Can't you tell?
Dear mio, what are you on about?
Oh, don't worry about it. It's just advertising. Warps the brain. How are you?
Not bad, not bad.
And Mr. M?
Oh, not too good, Joanne. He was laid off the job yesterday.
Oh, no.
Times are tough, cara mia.
My dad reckons it's because of the Asians taking all the jobs.
You know something, Joanne? They used to say that about us. 30 years ago, everyone was down on the Italians. They're taking the jobs. They live off the smell of an oily rag. They're bringing down the tone of the street. Today is the Vietnamese. Same story. The problem, cara mia, is not the Vietnamese. It's the lack of jobs.
There's another kid there doing work experience. Not from our school, though.
Oh, yeah?
His name's Min.
Min? What sort of a name's that?
He's Vietnamese. He's really nice, Dad. He wants to be an artist.
An artist? Well, fancy that. Is that so? And does he expect to get an income from being artistic, or will he be quite happy joining a doll queue like the rest of them?
Dad.
Well, why not, eh? Why work when he can get free handouts every week? Why bother when he can bludge off the taxpayers' money?
If they've got a job, they've taken it from someone else. And if they haven't, they're bludging off the taxpayer. They can't win.
She's got a point there, Ron.
The other thing is that people think they get huge handouts from the government when they first get here. They think they get houses and cars. Well, they don't. It's just lies. And they're made up by people like you so that you can find an excuse for hating them.
Joanne, now look, your father doesn't hate Asians. He doesn't hate anybody. Do you, Ron? Reporting itself has been restricted even further. Where
nobody's number one. Min, what is your trouble? Min.
Do they call you Ching Chong, Kiman? Do they say that to you? Do they say, go home? You're not wanted here? Do they?
Yes.
And what do you do?
I pretend they're not talking to me. You mustn't fight, Min. You mustn't give Vietnamese a bad name.
She's quite cute, that little Joanne, I reckon.
Yeah, not bad.
Pity she isn't a little older. I mean, I can't quite see myself chatting up a 15-year-old.
God, no. I think she's going to have to lose some weight, though. I mean, she's kind of cute now, but she's got the kind of body could easily go to fat.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
Even so, she's quite smart, that little lady.
As long as she doesn't get too smart. You know, that's what's great about Pammy. She's into being a career woman, okay. But she hasn't lost a sense of femininity, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
What's up?
Oh, it's just this place. It's getting to me.
Want to have lunch?
Sure. Hey, Min, what would you say if I said you'd be a really good graphic artist if you put on a bit more weight and became a bit more, you know, masculine?
I'll say you're an idiot.
Me too. Come on, let's go. I'm starved.
So how do I know what a real Aussie is?
What's a real Aussie anyway?
Well, he doesn't look like me, that's for sure.
Well, he doesn't look like me either. How many women are they looking at?
None.
Well, there goes half the population for a start.
I don't know what they really want, you know. I mean, I don't know what a real Aussie is supposed to be. Are you one?
Yeah, we all are. Look, if you live in Australia, you're an Australian. That figures, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Listen, I've just thought of something.
Yeah?
I've got this really great idea.
What have you two been up to, eh?
We've designed a commercial for the Aussie Lager campaign.
Well, well, well.
Not just a pretty face, huh?
Tony, put a sock in it.
Give us a look, then.
University tests have proved that Aussie Lager can make you a real Australian.
Until I tried Aussie Lager, I thought all beers were the same. But I can honestly say that no other beer can get my husband's skin this white, this bright, and so Australian.
I've been breeding and training pedigree Australian husbands for 10 years. And when you've got 10 Australian champions to care for, you know how important a healthy diet is. Husbands are an Australian sporting breed. I find that Aussie Lager helps them to grow into healthier, happier pets. Here, boy.
Did you hear the whistle, Snake? Beer's up. Never thought the whistle was going to be right.
If you love your pet, you'll give him Aussie Lager.
Aussie Lager, Aussie Lager, Aussie Lager.
6 months ago, my husband started a course of Aussie Lager. And in that time, he's grown 2 metres and his biceps are 9 times bigger than they were in April of last year.
My husband came to Australia 20 years ago from China. After 20 years of drinking Aussie Lager, he has become a real Australian.
Aussie Lager.
That's cute. I like it. Very droll. I like a person with a sense of humour. But of course, there's one problem which I think you'll appreciate. That wouldn't sell beer. But you know what I really think? You two have got a big career ahead of you.
You think you really like it, Pam?
Good morning. Well, at least he laughed. Can I help
you? We weren't trying to sell beer, you know.
We were trying to sell an idea.
I know. Thank you. But I tell you what, you certainly sold an idea to me.
I think you can enjoy it.
Thanks. Wouldn't it be really nice if I could get it in my mouth? What's it called?
Chopsticks.
I'm not that, you dag the food.
Fun sale.
What's that in Australian?
Meat pie and sauce.
Thank you.